which we were doing yesterday. Open your grammar books, all of you. We have done, yes, we have to do exercise. We were doing exercise D, page 32. All of you open your books, grammar books first. Exercise D, page number 32. Boys, keep your cameras on, all the boys. Keep your cameras on. Ali Hassan, Musaf, okay, fine. That's it. Muzammil, turn on your camera. Tabeen, you also. Page number is written. Exercise D, page number 32. Okay. I've told you that complete your work so that we can do it quickly and easily. Yesterday, we have done till part, I think, 6. Yes, 6. Now we will start from 7. Okay. Without wasting time, because we have to start a new chapter as well. So just raise your hand so that I can ask you one by one. Moving to the 7th one. I dash about you when you call. I dash about you when you call. Yes, Tabi.
I dash about you. I was thinking about you when you called.
Very good, Tabi. Correct. I was thinking about you when you called. Now, students, note it down in your grammar book also. If in a sentence there is simple past tense and there is a blank given, okay? So you will either fill in the blank with the past perfect or past continuous. Okay? So I was thinking about you when you called. Good. Next. Number 8. It is that we dash here for so long. Time period is involved. So perfect continuous. Who will do it? Yes, Roma. Yes, Roma, I've unmuted you.
Yeah.
Sir, we are working or we were working.
It's for so long that time period is involved. So we have been working. Yeah, we have been working. Okay, good, Roma, good try. We have been working here for so long. I've told you whenever a time period is mentioned, then you have to change the simple continuous to perfect continuous. And you have to put been in it. Okay? Number 9. I dash of moving to my hometown. I dash. Ali Hassan. Yes, Ali Hassan.
I was thinking of moving to my hometown.
Continuous form is correct. That is correct. But it is present continuous. I am thinking. Okay? I am thinking of moving to my hometown. It's very easy. Number 10. Good news. We dash to Nahran next month. Next month. Khatija.
We will go.
That is correct. Good news. We will go to Nahran next month. Simple future tense. Because it is next month, so it is simple future tense. Good. The doctor dashed a critical operation right now. Right now. At the moment. At the moment. Yes, Tabi.
The doctor has performed a critical operation right now.
So right now, action is operating now. Now, at the moment. So if it is acting at the moment, then it is present continuous. Okay? So the doctor is performing a critical operation right now. I've told you, whenever the word now or at the moment will come, then it is present continuous tense. Okay? Good try, Rabin. Number 12. Yes, Roma. Number 12. Yes. Vita, you have to unmute your mic, Roma. Okay, can some other, okay, Khadija.
They get energy from...
Yes, Khadija.
Why are you locking the cupboard again?
Why dash you? Action is done. Now what will come? Action is completed.
Why have you locked the cupboard again?
Why have you locked the cupboard again? Present perfect tense. Action is complete. Why have you locked the cupboard again? Okay, good beta. Next, we dash about the lack of facilities. Let's find ways to improve things. Action is completed. We dash about the lack of facilities. Musab.
We have complained.
Correct. Good. We have complained because action is done. We have complained about the lack of facilities. Let's find ways to improve things. Good, Musab. Tabi, turn on your camera, okay? Yes. Next, Roma. Number 14. Yes, Roma. I have unmuted you, beta. You have to unmute your mic.
Yes. She dashed you more than once to be careful. You need to heed her advice. She is telling...
She has told you more than once to be careful. You need to heed her advice. Means her action is completed. Okay, her action is complete. Good try, beta.
Okay.
Okay, good. Next. Ali Hassan. Okay, Ali Hassan. Ali Hassan, I've unmuted you. They dash us for quite some time now. Let's listen to them. Action is completed. Yes, Tabeen.
You have 15? Yes.
Bitter last one. Action is completed. For quite some time now.
They warned us.
Yes, they have warned. Action is completed. They have warned us. Okay. Now turn to page number 33 quickly. Page number 33. I see page number 33. Have you opened? Fill in the blanks with the specified future forms of the verbs in brackets. Now students, it's very easy for you people because they have mentioned which future form you have to use. First of all, you are going to tell me the verbs used in the, which are given in the bracket. What is the formula for future continuous? Musaf? First, yes, Musaf. Musaf, unmute your mic, then you can tell. Okay. Continuous tense will be first form of verb with
ing. Yes, teacher.
Which formula do we use in future continuous?
The first form of verb with ing.
Helping verb because it is future tense. Will be or shall be. Okay, write it down. Okay, write it down in your book. Write it down right now. And in perfect continuous, will have been. Okay, in perfect continuous, will have been. And in perfect, will have with the third form of verb. Will have with the third form of verb. I repeat, in future continuous, will be base. In continuous, you know, or whenever the word continuous comes, you have to put ing with the base verb. Okay? So you have to put ing with the base verb and helping verb will be. Perfect continuous, will have be. Perfect, will have, and with the third form of verb. Okay? Now we will start. Who will do the first one? Yes, Musab.
I will be calling.
Calling, correct. Correct. I will be calling you tonight to discuss this, or you can write I shall be calling you tonight to discuss this, because with I and be, we generally or normally put shall. But if you have written will, it is also correct. I will be calling you tonight to discuss this. Call will become calling. Number two, Tabi.
By next year, I dash for 7 years in this school. By next year, I will study for 7 years in this school.
Tabi, it is perfect continuous. In perfect continuous, you have to put will, have, be. What you have to put? Because it is future, so you will put will. And it is perfect, so you will put the helping verb of perfect have. And then you will join them with be. By next year, I shall have been, or I will have been, studying for 7 years in this school. Formulas must be clear, okay?
Okay.
The third one, Ali Hassan. Ali Hassan. It is continuous. It is simple continuous tense. Yes, Khadija.
Yes, teacher. He dash a large crowd tomorrow morning. He will be addressing.
Correct. She will be addressing. Continuous tense, so you will only put will be and put ing with the verb. Address will become addressing. She will be addressing a large crowd tomorrow morning. Number fourth. Yes, Tabi. Number fourth. It is bye, perfect.
By next week, I will complete my project.
Tabi, which verb do we put in perfect tense? Quickly tell me. Like in continuous, we are putting ing. In all perfect tenses, which verb do we put?
Will be completed.
Third form of verb. And because it is perfect tense, so we will put have. Will have. Okay? Will have. By next week, I will have completed, or I shall have, because it is obligation, responsibility, so you are going to put shall. By next week, I shall have completed my project. G. Fifth one is very easy. It is simple future tense. Roma.
Me.
They dash for us the river. As soon as they reach the resort.
Is it the simple future tense?
Will be going.
No. Going will come.
Will go.
Will go. Correct. Because will be going will become continuous. It is simple future. In simple future, we only remember in all future tenses, you have to put either will or shall. Okay, will comes with all the subjects and shall comes with I or V. Okay, so it is simple future tense, so they will go for a swim in the river. Number six. Yes, Maria Mujib. Yes, Maria Mujib.
In 5 years' time, we dash studying in college. We will be studying in college.
Correct. In 5 years' time, we will be studying in college. We shall be. Better try to put shall with I or V. Okay? I or V, put shall. We shall be studying in college. Formula is correct. Good. Next. Ali Hassan. Yes, Ali Hassan. Number seven. Yes, Ali Hassan.
By the time my mother comes home today, I dash the house. Cleaned.
And what verb will come? It is future. So, which helping verb we will put? It is future tense.
I will clean.
I will have cleaned or I shall have cleaned. Ali Hassan, in perfect tense, we put will have or shall have and third form of verb. Okay, good try. The more you will learn, the more you will practice, then you are going to learn. Yes, Kinsa has not participated. Yes, number 8th one. Who will tell me? Muzammil. Muzammil, why are you not participating? Tahir. Yes, now Muzammil, it's your turn. Do the 8th one. Naveen, turn on your camera. Yes, Muzammil. Unmute your mic, Muzammil and Tahir, both of you, and Shamim. Okay, Musaf. Do the 8th one.
When she arrives, I dash for 2 hours. When she arrives, I will be dancing for 2 hours.
I will have been. It is perfect continuous. I've told you when it is perfect continuous, you have to put the, I will give this homework to you people. You will make 5 sentences of each and every dance, okay? So when she arrives, I will have been dancing for 2 hours. Perfect, you have to put the helping verb of perfect tense, have, and dance will become dancing and you will join them with be. I will have been dancing for 2 hours. Number 9. Do the 9th one also, Musaf.
By the end of the month, they dash the flyover. By the end of the month, they will have constructed.
Good. They will have constructed. Good. Will have will come. Perfect tense, third form of verb, and will have. Good. Gee, the last one. The last one, who will do the last one? Raise your hand. Okay. Yes, Roma.
She dash in the concert tomorrow.
Concert.
Continues and not.
Which number baby? Huh?
She will be not singing in the concert tomorrow.
That is correct, but you will put not before be. She will not be singing. Okay? She will not be singing in the concert tomorrow. Good. Now, Vita, let's revise page number 34. This is your homework. Okay? All of you will do it and will show me on Monday. Okay? And then I will check it out. We will do it together quickly so that if there is any mistake, you can correct it in your books. And moreover, I'm going to give you sentences. You can take 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, or 8 days. But you are going to write all the sentences. Formulas, when I was explaining the slides to you, I have shown you all the formulas. So you can see on YouTube also, okay? And you can check your books also. Got it? And if still you have any problem, I will send you all the formulas in your notes. Okay, now all of you open your OPE, Oxford Progressive English. It's written unit 6, page 162. Page 162. I'm going to read the first page and explain it. Then you people will read and explain it. Okay? It's a newspaper report. Training lady to leading lady. Now, what does the term mean? Cleaning lady, who is a cleaning lady? As in the picture, you can see in the second picture, and you can get an idea that the lady is working so hard. She's cleaning the floors, the buildings, the shopping malls, the airports, okay? Leading is a person who leads, okay? Who makes other follow her. So the story, it's not basically a story, it's a report about a young girl. Peter, you need to wait for a minute, okay? Just open your books and read it quietly. Yes. So basically, it is a newspaper report about a lady, about a girl who faced a lot of hardships in her life, but she didn't give up. Okay, so I'm going to read it out. Leading lady to leading lady. This newspaper report is written by David Smith, arts and media correspondent. He who's working in this department. Paragraph 1. All of you need to have your pencils in your hand, okay? Note down the important meanings which I'm going to tell you. Starving, freezing, and bleeding. Sunan Yangchen lay down in the mountains to die. Starving, all of you know the meaning of starving. Hungry, okay, extremely hungry without having food. Freezing, it's extremely cold, okay, it's extremely cold. And bleeding, and she's injured also, okay. So three as an adjective, it's written over here, page number 162, okay. So Sunam is the name of the girl. Yang Chen lay down in the mountains to die. Without fear, the teenager embraced her faith. Okay, now the paragraph starts when Sunam is in the mountains and she is ready to die. she has accepted her fate, her destiny, that she is going to die in this manner. Okay? To freeze to death in the Himalayas. So where she is, in on which mountains? Himalayas. She is in the Himalayas and she has accepted her death, that she will die in this manner. Yes, Dabi? Yes, Vita. You want to ask anything, Roma? Yes? Who wants to ask? Okay.
टीचर वो आपने हमें रीडर के कितने चैप्टर में फोर्थ की करवाया है ना
बेटा यू हैव गॉट द रीडर्स विद यू
यस
यू पीपल हैव गिवन ओके फाइन यस फोर चैप्टर्स सो वी विल स्टार्ट इंशाल्लाह रीडर आल्सो आई वाज थिंकिंग दैट यू पीपल आर नॉट गिवन द रीडर्स सो यू हैव द रीडर्स विद यू
यस
यस मुसफ You want to ask something? But the time is short. I want teacher, to finish at least one page. Huh?
Teacher, वो जो आपने कल जब आप क्लास ले रही ना तो लाइट चली गई थी और नेट भी चला गया था तो जो आपने बाकी काम कराया था ना वो मेरा नहीं हुआ जो आपने शायद एक्सरसाइज सी करवाई थी उसके बाद मेरा डी के सेवन तक नहीं हुआ
ठीक है तो मुसफ आई विल You can ask any of your friend or we will revise it any one day, then you can complete. Okay?
Now, okay.
Let me finish. Okay? The family she had left behind in Tibet would never know what happened. Then a traveling companion who had gone on ahead turned back and rescued Sunak, giving her the strength to complete a harrowing. Harrowing means very hard, extremely upsetting. 6-week trek. Trek means to go on foot. A difficult journey, trek, a difficult journey completed on foot. Sabine, are you writing down? Don't turn off your camera. Write it down, beta. Write down the meanings. Across the mountains into Nepal. So basically in the first paragraph, the reporter is telling about Sonam Yangchen. She fled from Tibet, okay? And she was in the Himalayas. She fled with, fled means to run away. She ran away with some of the companions and she was stuck up in the mountains, the freezing mountains of Himalayas. And she was about all the people had left her over there. They had gone further ahead. So Sonam was thinking that she would die in this manner. She would freeze to death. It was extremely cold. It was snowing. And she was also hurt. And she had no food to eat. But at that time, one of her companions, I've told you the meaning of companions also. Companion is a person who gives company, who accompanies you on your journey, okay? So, one of the companions turned back and rescued Sonam. Rescued means to save somebody, okay? Giving her the strength to complete a harrowing 6-week trek. How long did they keep on traveling? For 6 weeks. You can multiply with 7 days, so it will become 42 days. Okay? 6 week trek. Across the mountains into Nepal. Having gained her first taste of freedom, the girl refused to end her journey there. Although the journey was extremely difficult, dangerous, but Sonam didn't give up because she wanted freedom. She wanted freedom. Sabin, turn on your camera. Okay? Now, paragraph number two. This paragraph. Paragraph number two. 14 years later. Now we are talking when she left the her home city, when she left her hometown. At that time, she was a teenager. All of you know what is a teenager? From 13 till 19. You are a teenager. Okay? Now in paragraph 2, we are talking about 14 years later. 14 years later and thousands of miles away, the refugee will start tonight. Refugee is a person who is given shelter in some other city, in some other country. Okay, so Sunam became a refugee. She was given a shelter, a home, or a place to live in England. The refugee, so who is the refugee here? Refugee is Sunam. Who is refugee? Sunam. We'll start tonight in a glittering gala. Gala is a very big occasion. A public gathering, a big public gathering where many people come and attend, like sports gala. Your parents come, children come. Okay, so gala is a special occasion. At the Royal Opera House, Royal Opera House is the name of a house where music is played. Okay, like a concert is held, musical concert is held. It's the proper noun, it's the name of the house. Royal Opera House in London's Covent Garden. Okay, so we are talking about, in the next paragraph, we are talking about 14 years later. 14 years later, the refugee was going to sing in the London's Covent Garden at the Royal Opera House. She was a good singer. Now, Sunam is 28 years old after 14 years. When she left, she was a teenager, and now she is 28 years old. Will perform her haunting Tibetan mountain songs. Okay, she's going to perform, she's going to sing a song, Tibetan song. Tibet is in Nepal, and that was her family or hometown, which she left because she was badly treated there. Songs at a one, this sign, this symbol, can you see the symbol 130? It's palm. 130 pound ahead concert in the Venues Villar Floral Hall to raise money for the Tibet Relief Fund. Now, Sunam is going to sing the Tibetan mountain songs, and she will get money for that, and she is going to raise money to contribute in the Tibet Relief Fund. Okay? So she is basically raising money. She is collecting money for the Tibet Relief Fund. Sunam hopes that an evening for Tibet will help her find a record producer as she strives to launch a career. Now, basically, Sunam is looking for a career in the field of music. So she believes that now if she's going to sing songs, somebody will find her and will offer her a good job. As she strives to launch a career that can help reunite her with the daughter she has seen only once in 9 years. She had a daughter also, which you will study in the coming paragraphs. But she hasn't seen her daughter in 9 years. Okay, so she's collecting money to help her reunite with her daughter. Now, paragraph number 3. After reading this, then you are going to read. The singer-songwriter, Sunam is not only a singer, she's also a writer. She also writes songs, okay? So that is why it is written, the singer-songwriter now makes ends meet. Now makes ends meet is an idiom. It means earns money. Earns money. By working shifts as a cleaner at Brighton Police Station, she is not only writing songs or singing songs, she's also working as a cleaner at the Brighton Police Station. Okay? Where? At Brighton Police Station. You are going to write the summary on your own, Muzammil. Yet she is grateful for the opportunities offered by Britain after years of Chinese persecution. Persecution is a cruel treatment, ill treatment, to treat somebody badly. Okay, note down the meanings. Of a family in Tibet, which she fled at the age of 15 in December 1989. Underline this line. She left Tibet in December 1989 because her family was badly treated by the Chinese. At that time, Tibet was under the control of Chinese and they were badly treated. So that is why Sonam left her city, that is Tibet, in December 1989. My family were nobles. Nobles were rich people. Okay, she said. In the Cultural Revolution, when Chinese over controlled Nepal, Tibet, at that time, she's saying that our possessions, possessions means property, house, land, things like that, were taken and our home was demolished. Demolished means destroyed. Better tomorrow, on Monday, I'm going to ask you people. So please be very careful. Ali Hassan, Tabin, or both of you. Turn on your camera, both of you. Tabin, you also. My parents were worried for my safety, so they sent me to live at a family friend's house. I was 6 or 7 and lived a slave's life. So her parents sent her to a family friend, but they were very bad with Sonam. They treated her like a slave. She did all the work the whole day. She did dishwashing and laboring, cleaning, sweeping. Many years later, when her parents sent her to live at a family friend's house, she was 6 years old at that time. So after many years, she escaped. I went with two monks. Monks are the like people who work in a church, religious people, okay? And a friend to try to reach Nepal. But the police recognized the monks because their hair was shaved. Shaved means cut off. My friend was taken away, so I was left on my own at the border for 3 weeks seeking other companions. People want me not to go on my own. So after many years, Sonam escaped Tibet with two monks and her friend. But the police recognized the monks and they arrested them. And her friend was also taken away and she was left alone on the border. She was looking for the other companions and the people told her that she should not go further on her own. Okay, students? Now, any confusion? On Monday, I'm going to listen. You have to explain it also. Okay? And you have to tell me the meanings also. All the remaining, can you tell me, Kay, which was the last chapter I sent you? Yes. Which was the last chapter I sent you? Tahir?
Did you think it's the revenge?
No. Right. No. How much land does a man need? You have got the notes of how much land does a man need?